and copper's integral in it, right? So we're optimistic that the government's going to be supportive of these projects and that they're going to look to work with the companies to push them forward. And you know, we're all for that.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Darryl Jones. He's the CEO of starcoppercorp. And Darryl, it's good to see you. How are you?
Well, very well, Steve. Thanks. Thanks for seeing us today.
Yeah, excited to have you along. A little bit more about what the company's doing. I know there's some work that's happening right now. We'll get into in just a second. But first, maybe just give everyone a bit of background on the company itself.
Wonderful. Yeah. So Star Copper is a former Alpha Copper Corp. And it spun out of a idea when I was on the board of Alpha Lithium, which was a successful transaction in the lithium space about 3 years ago. Myself, Brad Nichols, Sean Charland, all founding directors of that company, ventured out and we started Alpha Copper Corp, which ultimately acquired the Star asset. And here we are today with Star Copper.
Yeah, tell me a bit about that asset. What'd you like about it?
Well, it's excuse me, it's a historically worked project. It was owned in 2013, 2014 by a company that spent about $10 million of today's money on the project. There's 16,000 meters of drilling, geophysics, geochem, everything is all done and ready. And we've just picked the ball up and run with the drilling here. So we're drilling out what we know as a supergene zone or an oxide zone at surface and testing the depth of the known deposit and then looking to expand on four of the new targets, which are there.
Yeah, and your most recent press release talks specifically about that, the fact that you just gave a sort of an update on what's going on as far as drilling is concerned and sort of the area you're looking into.
We embarked on our maiden drill program start of June with the understanding that we wanted to reconfirm the existing drilling on that sort of high-grade zone and then test the sort of fault structures associated with the mineralization. So we're well into it. We're just finishing up that first program, which was about $2.5 million. And we're excited because, like I said, there's more than one target here, which looks just like the main zone. So Star North, Star East, very similar geophysical, geochemical signatures. And we're excited to test that in what would be a phase two here really shortly.
Yeah, Darryl, maybe you can sort of talk about the size of it. When you mentioned the sort of the main zone, are we talking about a large part of the property? Or are you only working on a smaller area with a lot of potential outside of that as well?
Yeah, it's quite a small area. The Star Main is about a 500 meter by 500 meter geochemical target. And then that oxide zone sort of sits in there. We're expanding that right now. And then about a kilometer away from that, we have, again, Star North, which is a lookalike geophysical signature, soil sampling, trenching, all done up there, which, you know, is exciting because we're going to get to drill that soon. And then just south of that, it's called Star East. You know, it doesn't really make a lot of sense, but Star East is another geophysical target. Same thing, soils, you know, IP, magnetics, all done on the project, another lookalike. So sort of within a 3 kilometer range on the project, which again is still very small in terms of the scope of the project, we've got three of these sort of fingers coming up, and the thesis or the model would be to connect them and say that this is a large porphyry cluster in a known area where large porphyry deposits are very common.
Yeah, along with the drilling, you're also doing some field work as well. Is that sort of just preparatory work for getting ready for the eventual drilling down the road? Is sort of give me an idea of what you're doing?
Yeah, so like I said, the project is well worked. There's an extensive network of trails and roads already there. Okay. We are picking up the ball and running with it. So, you know, over 10 years, the trails close in. So we're just clearing those out. We're getting ready. The pads are built at Star North. We're just getting the pads ready at Star East. And then we're sort of working our way over to another target, which is a little more grassroots, but it's had some historic drilling, the Copper Creek area. You know, but clearing brush and getting all that stuff done while you're working on drilling is, you know, we're pressing forward as best we can. You know, because ultimately this project is a year round project. It's not heavily covered in snow. We can work it all the way up until, you know, Christmas time effectively. And so that's the goal.
And finally, Darryl, are you realizing or hearing more about the support for a project like this, especially when copper is concerned? I know the Premier David Eby has talked to specifically about the importance of metals within British Columbia. Are you sort of hearing that and feeling that as well?
Yeah, I mean, we're hearing, the critical minerals, being copper for us specifically, are exceptionally important. There's a massive opportunity for, the greenification or this new tech economy, and copper's integral in it, right? So we're optimistic that the government's going to be supportive of these projects and that they're going to look to work with the companies to push them forward, and we're all for that. So.
Yeah, good times for sure. Darryl, I know there's a lot of work ahead. We look forward to following the story as it develops and really appreciate your time today as well. Thank you.
Oh, great. Thanks. Thanks, Steve.
Darryl Jones, the CEO of Star Copper Corp.